Yo, what is going on, guys? It's Cryptic TMG. We're back with a brand new video. We're actually doing a race around Barcelona in LFM. We're in the Bentley, and we're going to see what we can manage to do. It is pitch black, man. Seriously dark night race. I always seem to end up in night races, bro. And I'll be honest, man. My monitor, I can't see jack. I can't see. My last sectors have been terrible because I literally can't see the curbs, man. And, for some reason, I don't know if you guys have seen it, but the latest update on the NVIDIA graphics card, it's sort of broken the control panel, so I can't even change the video settings. So I can't change like the contrast or the brightness or the gamma or anything, man. I'm out here struggling, but I'm on pole position in the Bentley, so let's just see, man. Let's just see. Hopefully, we can get a good start and see what we can do from there. But this is gonna be a struggle. I'm so down bad right now. Trying to see, it's insane. Anyway, we're starting on pole. We're on the inside, so it should be half decent at least. Hopefully, I got the pressures right. I'll put my TC down to 2 so I can get a better start. These brakes warm. Stall the turbo so we can get a good start. Great start. Quali was pretty close as well, man, so it'll be tough. Short shifting out of some of the corners. That's literally where I struggle. That precise part of the chicane, the first part, is very hard to see on my monitor. Back end sliding. Definitely the toughest part is actually seeing, man. It wasn't too bad. I think the Bentley's a bit of a rocket ship down the straight, so I don't think that part will be a struggle. Back end still wants to kick out, even in third gear through turn three. They make up so much in the last sector. That's pretty much where I lose all my advantage, man. Last sector sucks right now. I think us two are pulling away from everybody else now. Wish I had some consistency in the last sector. It was a bit quicker that time, 10th and a half. I think the Ferrari's got some pretty heavy BRP around here, so it could possibly affect the tyres. But despite the difference in BRP, the Ferrari's definitely still a quicker car around here. definitely does gain a couple temps in that last chicane, man. This time he sets the fastest lap. Both improving on this lap. Broke slightly too late. Still half a second. Made a mistake. Uh-oh. Whoops. That was going to be a good lap. Oh, he lost a second on that lap. I do wish this was at daytime though. That corner's literally invisible for me. Bad lap. He throws the gap on that lap. Oops, a little bit wide. Takes a lot out of me in the braking zones for sure. Another poor lap. Rear tire sliding across the surface. Getting a little bit skittish at the rear. Getting slower and slower at the moment. Definitely beginning to slide. Back end stepping out through there. Oops, overshot. The last sector is definitely hard at the moment. Oh, he made another mistake. Oh, he made a big mistake. Oh, the consistency is key, man. Definitely got enough fuel. I think I'm chilling. I can see the difficulties that people picking the Bentley will have, for sure. It feels like with the Bentley, like, you have to be perfect, you know? Like, once you miss your braking slightly, there's just no rescuing it with the Bentley, man. The rear end is definitely getting more and more happy, for sure. At the very least, at least the pace has come down gradually and not just, you know, 7/8 tenths just complete drop off, you know. That's where I'm losing the pace, just that little bit of rear end sliding. It's only a few corners, so it is manageable. I think it helps that my tire pressures are pretty good. Jesus. Mid corner, third gear. Back end is not happy. But at least it's very controllable. Right, last lap, lads. Whatever the mistake the guy behind made, definitely killed his tires. Because he was putting the pressure on. Man, what line I take into there, same outcome. The traction's still good out of the slow corners, it's the fast corners. Got to remember to short shift, man. Wasn't cool. Right, we made it. Sheesh. Man. Hey, that was tough, man. It seems straightforward, but night racing sometimes is just an absolute mess. Actually, that guy came third, so we lost position. I think dude in a white Ferrari came third. He did lose position. No way. No way. What? Oh, man. How has he done that? Made a mistake. We clinched it in the Bentley, man. I was not the fastest guy on the track, but I did have some good consistency, man. So 43.7. I think three of us were doing 43.7s, man. Let me have a look at my last sector because I just feel like it was appalling. Best last sector was a 0.5. Wasn't too bad. You can see I get like for most of the race that last sector was a struggle. I did 1.5 and that was it. Every other time was a complete and utter struggle. Middle sector pretty much was pretty sound, probably apart from the last lap. Yeah. I don't know, man. The Bentley is definitely hard work. I would be able to tell a little bit more if we were doing it in the daytime and I was actually able to see the corners. For whatever reason, man, normally when it's a race like this, I normally mess with the NVIDIA control panel settings just to make it a little bit brighter so I can actually see. But for some reason, that's broken at the moment. So when I tell you, I don't know if when you guys watch this, I don't know whether it's going to be as dark for you as it is for me. But my monitor is pretty dark anyway. So trust me, that last chicane was extremely hard to see the entry to that, man. Extremely hard. I feel like that definitely would have cost me some time, but we still managed to get the win. That's the important thing. Some more ranking points and stuff like that for LFM. Anyway, guys, it's Cryptic TNG. Like and subscribe. Hit the notification bell to catch my videos first. And peace. Who is the way?